Today we are going to know how to draw the ray diagrams by using both biconvex lens and as well as biconcave lens. What is the use of these ray diagrams? These ray diagrams is used to know how to calculate the focal length of a lens. By calculating the focal length of the lens, we may use such kind of the lenses mainly in the optics, means to rectify the eye defects, to use in the telescopes, to use in the microscopes, to use in the kaleidoscopes, and various such kind of the applications. Nowadays we are producing different kinds of the sounds by using lenses also. That system is called DTS, digital track system, which contain lens. That much importance is there for the ray diagrams. Let us study how to draw a ray diagram. If you observe the ray diagrams of these cases, the light rays are traveling parallel to the principal axis of a biconvex lens. Here, these light rays are traveling parallel to the principal axis of a biconcave lens. After traveling the light rays parallel to the principal axis, they undergo the process of refraction and they converge at a point on the principal axis. That converging point is called focus. If we consider in the case of biconcave lens, the light rays which are traveling parallel to the principal axis of a biconcave lens undergo the process of refraction and deviate away from the principal axis but appear to be coming from a point on the principal axis. That point is called focus. Now let us draw these diagrams on a paper. See, here I already drawn a principal axis and I identified some of the points which are at equidistance. Approximately the distance is considered as 2 centimeters. Then you can draw the diagrams easily and perfectly. So in the first diagram, I am going to use a biconvex lens. This is the representation of biconvex lens. Consider this is the focus one and center of curvature, which is also represented as 2f1, and this is the focus two, center of curvature, which is also represented as 2f2. Here in this, the light rays are traveling parallel to the principal axis. Light rays are traveling parallel to the principal axis. Then what happens? If the light rays travel parallel to the principal axis of a biconvex lens, they undergo the process of refraction. Refraction is nothing but bending. That bending is towards the point. That point is located on the principal axis. Now that point is called focus. That means biconvex lens converging the light rays. Biconvex lens converges the light rays. For that sake only biconvex lens is also called converging lens. If you observe in the case of biconcave lens, here biconcave lens that we are doing now. For that purpose, again we should draw a principal axis, identify the midpoint. From the midpoint onwards, identify the points which are at equidistance. I am considering 2 centimeters distance. Now at the very center, this point act as an optic center. At the optic center, I am drawing a biconcave lens representation. Now, in the biconcave lens, it is in the opposite direction. This can be F1 and 2F1, F2 to F2. You should understand the difference between biconvex lens and biconcave lens. Now, what happens? If the light rays are traveling parallel to the principal axis of a biconcave lens, they undergo the process of diverging, but they are appear to be coming from a point on the principal axis. That point is called focus. Even this light ray also undergo the process of divergence, but appear to be coming from that point. That point is called focus. This means, in the case of biconvex lens, it is a real focus. In the case of biconcave lens, it is an apparent focus. Means the light rays are appear to be diverged. Once again, if you observe from the textbook, the diagrams are given like this. The light rays are traveling parallel to the principal axis of a biconvex lens, whose symbol is given, undergo the process of convergence. After converging, they appear to be passing through the focus. Here, they appear to be diverged from the point that is called focus. So, biconvex lens is a converging lens. Biconcave lens is a diverging lens. But whatever it may be, the lens must and should contain two foci, two center of curvature. The distance between optic center, the distance between optic center and focus is called focal length. The focal length is on either side of the lens must and should be equal. Here also, the distance between optic center and focus is called focal length, represented by letter F. If you observe here, the light rays which are passing through the optic center of either biconvex lens or biconcave lens does not deviate. The rays passing through the optic center of either biconvex lens or biconcave lens does not deviate from its path. Means they travel in a straight line. Let us know how to draw the ray diagram in this issue. Now, here, as usual, we are going to draw a principal axis. Identify the midpoint on the principal axis. From that point onwards, mark the points which are at equidistance. And here, we should draw biconvex lens. This is the representation of biconvex lens. This point is F1 and 2F1, F2, 2F2. Now the light rays are traveling through optic center. They are undeviated. Means they travel without any deviation. That means they does not undergo the process of either convergence or divergence. Now, in the case of biconcave lens, these light rays are traveling through the optic center of biconcave lens. What happens? They does not deviate. Let us discuss this by using a ray diagram. For that purpose, we should draw the principal axis at first, then identify the center point. From the center point onwards, identify the points which are at equidistance. Here in this case, I am considering 2 centimeters each. Why? Because to get the ray diagram in an accurate manner. At the center point is considered as optic center. at the optic center, draw the biconcave lens. In this biconcave lens, this side F1 and 2F1, F2 and 2F2. Now, the light rays are traveling through the optic center, means like this, at certain angle. Whenever the light ray travel like that, it does not deviate. Means here the light ray travel in straight line. From this case, we should understand that any light ray traveling through the optic center does not deviate. Any light ray traveling through the optic center does not deviate. The lens may be whether it is biconvex lens or biconcave lens. Now, if you observe the figure 9A and 9B from our textbook, here the light ray is traveling along the principal axis of biconvex lens. In this diagram, the light ray is traveling along the principal axis of a biconcave lens. In these two cases, light ray undeviated. Totally, light ray is undeviated in two cases. Whenever it is traveling through the optic center of the given lens, and it is traveling along the principal axis of the given lens. Let us know how to draw these ray diagrams. Now, to draw these ray diagrams, as usual, we are drawing the principal axis. Identify the midpoint, this point act as optic center. From that point, we should locate the points which are at equidistance. These points act as in different cases. At the optic center, draw the biconvex lens. Why? Because here in the diagram, we are considering the biconvex lens. Now, on the biconvex lens, right hand side, it is F1 and 2F1. Here, F2, 2F2. 2F1 act as center of curvature 1. 2F2 act as center of curvature 2. Now, here the light ray is traveling along the principal axis. It is undeviated. Like that, we should draw the ray diagram in this case. Now, move on to the biconcave lens. Here, the given lens is a biconcave lens. How to draw the ray diagram for this? Once again, first of all, we should draw the principal axis. Identify the center point. This center point acts as optic center. From that center onwards, I am going to identify the various points with the equidistance 2 to 2 centimeters. I am considering only the 2 to 2 centimeters. Whatever it may be, the equal distances you can consider. At the center, we should draw biconcave lens. This is the representation of biconcave lens. Focus 1, focus 2. Means this is the center of curvature 1. F2, 2F2. This is the center of curvature 2. Now, in this case also, if the light ray travel along the principal axis, if the light ray passing through the principal axis, it is undeviated. Here also, the light ray does not deviate from its path. So totally, in two cases, light ray does not deviate from its path. That is, whenever it is traveling through optic center, whenever the light is traveling through the optic center, it is not deviated. When the light is traveling through the principal axis of either biconvex lens or biconcave lens also does not deviate. If we observe figure 11A and 11B of SCERT 10th class textbook, here the object is placed at focus of a biconvex lens. The light rays that are coming from the focus
fall on the biconvex lens, undergo the process of deviation. After the deviation, they are traveling parallel to the principal axis. It is the opposite position to this position. Here in this case, light rays are traveling parallel to the principal axis and they are converging at a point on the principal axis is called focus. Here in this case, light rays are coming from the focus. After the refraction, they travel parallel to the principal axis. Let us draw how to draw this ray diagram. For this purpose, draw the principal axis, identify the points as optic center and as well as focus and center of curvatures. Consider this point as optic center and this is F1 to F1, F2 to F2. At the optic center, draw the biconvex lens. The light rays are coming from focus. We can draw many number of the light rays that is coming from the focus. If the light rays are coming from the focus and falls on the lens axis, undergo the process of refraction. After the refraction, they travel parallel to the principal axis. That means what we can understand. It is a converging position. If the light rays travel parallel to the principal axis of biconvex lens, undergo the process of refraction and they converges at focus. If the light rays are coming from focus, they undergo refraction and travel parallel to the principal axis. Now observe in the case of a biconcave lens. Same concept in the case of a biconcave lens. For that purpose, again draw the principal axis. Identify the center points with equidistance. I am considering 2 centimeters, means every point is at a distance of 2 centimeters. The center point is considered as optic center. At the optic center, draw a biconcave lens. Here biconvex lens and biconcave lens. In the case of biconcave lens, like this, we are going to identify the focus and as well as center of curvatures. Now the light rays are coming from focus, means they are traveling in the direction of focus. In the direction of focus, see here, in this direction the light ray is coming in this direction. Once again, if we consider one more light ray, the light ray is coming in the direction of focus. They undergo the process of refraction and diverges. I already said biconcave lens is a diverging lens. Then what happens? They travel parallel to the principal axis. Here also they travel parallel to the principal axis. Like this. In this case, clearly we can understand that whenever the light ray is traveling in the direction of focus of a biconcave lens, undergo the process of refraction. After the deviation, they travel in the direction, that means parallel to the principal axis. In this case, the light rays are traveling parallel to each other, but they are not traveling parallel to the principal axis. They are falling at some angle with the principal axis. The light rays which are traveling parallel to each other and making some angle with the principal axis, falls on the biconvex lens, undergo the process of converging and converges at a point on focal plane. Now, what is meaning of a focal plane? See here, a dotted line is drawn. This dotted line is passing through the focus and perpendicular to the principal axis. It is an imaginary line. An imaginary line drawn perpendicular to the principal axis at focus is called focal plane. An imaginary line drawn perpendicular to the principal axis at focus is called focal plane. Now, let us discuss how to draw this ray diagram. As usual, first draw the principal axis. Identify the points which are at equidistance on either sides. Now, the center point is considered as the optic center. At the optic center, we should draw the biconvex lens. This point is F1 to F1. This is center of curvature 1, F2 to F2, center of curvature 2. Now, before itself, I am drawing the focal plane. Focal plane is nothing but the imaginary plane which is drawn perpendicular to the principal axis at focus. Now, the light rays are traveling parallel to each other, but they are making some angle with the principal axis. Now, what happens? After falling there, they undergo the process of refraction and converges at a point. That point is nothing but focus. So, here also the light rays are traveling parallel to each other and they met at a point. That point locates on focal plane. Now, see here, the definition of focal plane is given. The imaginary plane that drawn perpendicular to the principal axis at focus, either it may be a biconvex lens or a biconcave lens. Now, we are going to draw the same situation in the case of biconcave lens. For the same category, draw the principal axis. Identify the points which are at equidistance. These points can be represented as optic center. Draw the biconcave lens at the optic center. Now, this point is considered as F2 to F2 and this point is considered as F1 and as well as 2F1. F2 is nothing but center of curvature 2. F1 is nothing but center of curvature 1. Now, consider the light rays are traveling parallel to the principal axis. Before going to that, we should draw the focal plane, the imaginary line drawn through the focus, which is perpendicular to the principal axis. Now, some of the light rays are traveling parallel to each of them, but they are making certain angle with the principal axis. Then what happens? They undergo the process of deviation, but they appear to be coming from a point. That point is called focus. This focus is not a real focus. It is an apparent focus in the case of biconcave lens. So, the light rays are deviated by a biconcave lens. Biconcave lens always deviates the light rays in both the directions.